شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear brothers and sisters and respected elders, I hope you are all well. Welcome to one of our videos where, inshallah, today we'll be starting some topics about the month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, we are a few weeks away from Ramadan starting, so inshallah these videos will benefit you. So I have here with me brother Lotfi Jafar. Assalamu alaikum, my brother.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Good to see you, brother.
Thank you.
What advice can you give us in terms of what are the most rewarding acts that we can do in the month of Ramadan?
Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Muhammadin nabiyyillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa mawalah. The best acts of worship that a Muslim can increase in doing in the blessed month of Ramadan are two. Mm-hmm. Number one, fasting. And number two, reading the Quran. Mm-hmm. And we can add one to it too, and that is giving charity. One might ask, it is obvious that fasting is the best because Ramadan is all about fasting.
Sure.
But what I mean by fasting is by fasting according to the Sunnah, fasting the way the Prophet ﷺ taught us, fasting with the etiquettes of fasting, mm-hmm. adab sawm, the mannerism of fasting. You fast with your entire body, not just depriving yourself from eating and drinking, but you stop yourself also from where? From gazing at that which is haram, from touching that which is haram, from saying that which displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you fast with your entire body limbs and with your heart. So fasting is number one, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الشَّهْرَ فَلْيَصُمْهُ. Whoever witnesses the blessed month of Ramadan, then they must fast in it. That's number one. And number two, the most rewarding action that a Muslim can do in the blessed month of Ramadan is the Quran. To read the Quran, recitation of the Quran, reflecting on the Quran, and so on and so forth. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس. The month of Ramadan is the month where the Quran was revealed, or when the Quran was revealed. So it's the month of fasting as well as the month of the gracious book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Read as much Quran as you can. And if you try to memorize, it's even better. If you try to revise, it's even better, alhamdulillah. And if you can add to that the meaning of the Quran, some tafsir, so you can reflect on it and act on it, and that's even better, inshallah ta'ala. So the Quran. And thirdly, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم كان أجود الناس يعني في شهر رمضان وفي غيره أكيد. He was صلى الله عليه وسلم the most generous صلى الله عليه وسلم in the month of Ramadan, and of course outside the month of Ramadan too صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about charity in the Quran al-Kareem repeatedly. وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Give from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you. Because charity is very special in the month of Ramadan. Why? Because there is lots of Muslims and lots of people who fast, and they're needy and they're poor, and they don't have enough food to put on the table after don't know how many hours of fasting. They don't have sahur. They don't have basic essentials that every Muslim should have in their fridge and in their kitchen. So this charity will help and will make sure that everyone is fed and everyone is drinking and everyone is fasting and worshipping Allah during the daylight and at iftar time and at night time. So these are the best, because without them eating or drinking, they would not be able to complete this great worship fasting or read the Quran. So like this, so you're doing it for yourself, and you're doing it for others when you give charity, inshallah ta'ala. So I would say these are the best three worships.
Yeah. Sure. One of the things you mentioned is reading the Quran, which is a very rewarding act that one can do. What advice would you give to somebody that perhaps their knowledge in reading the Quran is not good. Say somebody who knows very little Arabic, or you know, there, would you say how should they push themselves towards that? I mean, obviously learning the Quran is most important, but some may dismiss that fact because they don't know how to read.
Yeah.
You know, they haven't learned while they were young,
yeah.
And they may be an adult, and they skip that part because they don't know how to do it. What advice would you give?
It is very important for every Muslim to understand what is their duty with the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it is our guide, it is our religion, it is our way to Allah. Without it, there is no Islam. Simple as that. Mm. So a Muslim who's wise should ask, what is my duty towards the Book of Allah? And therefore, you need to remember this, brothers and sisters. Without these four, then we're failing the Quran.
Mm-hmm.
And they are in a chronological order, one by one. You do the first one, and then you move second, third, to the last one, fourth. The first one is to learn how to read it as correctly as you can.
Right.
I am very precise with my words. As correctly as you can. People have different abilities, okay? So I'm not saying as perfectly as you can, as correctly, but because what matters in the Quran is when you read it correct. This is the most basic. This is what mostly needed. You read it as correctly as you can, and you memorize some of it if you can't memorize all of it.
Mm-hmm.
What do I mean by that? It is recommended to memorize as much Quran as you can, because the more you memorize, the higher rank you will have on the Day of Judgment, inshallah ta'ala. But if you can't memorize all of it, then memorize what you can, inshallah ta'ala. Because Muslims cannot be Muslims without knowing Surah Al-Fatiha, Surah Qul Huwallahu Ahad.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't know Quran, then you don't know who Allah is.
Sure.
You don't know who Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam is. You don't know what Islam is. Right? Because it's the main source of Islam, including the Sunnah of our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. So you learn, you memorize some of it. And you learn how to read it as correctly as you can. Basic rules of tajweed and so on and so forth. So you have to hire a teacher.
Mm-hmm.
You have to go to a madrasa. If you are parents and you have kids, then you must take them, join the madrasa. And if you are a parent yourself or an adult yourself and you did not learn when you were young, it's never too late. You can still learn. Go to some masajid, go to some madrasas. They offer classes for adults.
Sure.
If not, make sure you hire a private teacher, one-to-one. You pay money, yes.
Mm-hmm.
You pay money, just like you pay money for personal training, just like you pay money for whatever services you have, for your entertainment or for your Sky TV or whatever it is, or sport channels, or then pay for the Quran. Why not?
Yeah,
why not?
100%.
So you hire a teacher, private teacher, one-to-one, 1 hour a week, 2 hours a week, whatever you can afford. And you learn bit by bit. What matters, you are on your journey learning the Quran. You're not abandoning the Quran. That's what matters.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a hadith in Sahih Muslim, the hadith of Aisha, he says, "Al-mahiru bil Quran ma'a al-kiram al-barara." The one who masters the Quran will be with the noble angels on the Day of Judgment.
Mm-hmm.
والذي يقرأ القرآن وهو يتتعتع به وهو يشق عليه أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم له أجران. And as for the one who reads the Quran with struggling, you know, he can't really read, whether it is pronunciation or he doesn't know how to join the letters, he's trying his best, but this is all he can do. So for such people, they will have two rewards. One reward for trying their best, and the second reward for reading the Quran itself.
Sure.
But the one who masters the Quran is much better. Why? Because he will be in the highest ranks with the angels on the Day of Judgment.
Mm-hmm.
Because he invested more time and he challenged himself and read and memorized and spent nights not sleeping, revising, memorizing, learning, and so on and so forth. So the reward is not different. It's not the same. Mm-hmm. So the first one is to learn how to read as correctly as you can and memorize some of it, if not all, inshallah ta'ala. Okay? Obligation number two will be to learn the meaning of the Quran.
Mm-hmm.
You do not have to be an expert like Ibn Kathir or Tabari or Al-Qurtubi, of course. We don't mean that. Of course, if you can, alhamdulillah, if you have the capacity and the ability, be more than those, okay, if you can. But what we mean in here, at least for layman Muslims, at least they learn what alhamdulillah means, qul wallahu ahad, ayat al-kursi, especially this surah and these verses, which the Sunnah came with special rewards for reciting them and so on and so forth, such as Ayatul Kursi after each salat, your prayer obligation salat, before you sleep, such as Al-Mu'awwidhatayn, as Ruqyah, such as Al-Fatiha, you read it 17 times a day, such as the surah, the reward when reading it is, it's like you read one third of the Quran and the surah Al-Ikhlas. Mm-hmm. So this surah, Muslims cannot afford, no matter where you are, from Pakistan or from Sweden or from China or from Africa, if you're not an Arab, it doesn't matter. You need to learn this meanings of these basic surahs and verses from the gracious Quran, inshallah ta'ala, in your own translation, your own language, inshallah ta'ala. So you learn the tafsir, inshallah ta'ala. And the third one will be, once you know how to read it and then you understand it, the next step is to act upon it, to act. Because now you understand what your Lord is telling you.
Yeah.
You understand what Allah is telling you in His gracious book. So you have to do what He tells you to do and stay away from what He tells you to stay away from. Simple as that. He says, pray. He says, obey your parents, obey my parents. Fast Ramadan. Give charity. Take care of your neighbors. Simple as that. Mm-hmm. It's not complicated at all. This is what it means to act upon the Quran. Sure. To do what Allah says and to avoid what Allah tells you to stay away from. Simple as that. We don't have to complicate it to anyone. Mm-hmm. The fourth one, after you read it, you understood it, you act on it, share it with others. Mm-hmm. Share it with others. As the hadith of Uthman ibn Affan, خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. The best one of you is the one who learns the Quran and then shares it or teaches it to others. So, and again, you don't have to be a teacher in a madrasa or in a masjid or in a university to teach the Quran. This differs from one to another, really. You as a parent, it will count for you as if you teach your kid or your daughter or your son or your wife, or you teach them, then you will fit in this hadith. You get the reward for that, inshallah. Of course, it differs, the ranks and how much reward you get and how much a teacher gets. It differs, of course. But you're reviving the sunnah. You're doing at least your best, you understand. So the last one is to teach the Quran, inshallah ta'ala. Da'wah, which means to give da'wah.
Of course, definitely.
Yeah. So these are the obligations. And so someone who can't read it, they have to go for a private teacher. And they read it according to their ability. We know, we've been teaching Quran for some time now. Some people, even if you repeat 10 times, 15 times, they will repeat the same mistakes. Even if he reads it this week, next week, the week after, he would, you know, repeat those mistakes. We don't put them off. We can't tell them, oh, you're not going to learn. We tell them, you're doing that. Keep doing that because you're getting more reward.
Mm-hmm.
You get what matters, you don't stop doing that. Yes. Even if you get it wrong, continue reading the Quran, continue your relationship with the Quran, and that's your goal. Your aim is to be connected to the Quran.
Mm-hmm.
That's the main aim, to be master of the Quran and to read it like proper Quran. This is an extra virtue. It's not wajib. It's not wajib. No.
Right, okay. Well, may Allah give us the time to reach Ramadan and let us start fixing up ourselves so that when Ramadan comes, those good deeds become even more rewarding. So inshallah, you know, we're only a few weeks away, so let's make a start right now. Encourage our kids, our friends, our colleagues, everyone, you know, to look at themselves and make those changes, inshallah. Make sure you like, subscribe and share these videos. So sharing also, you will take some of that reward as well. When somebody else benefits from it, so you will as well. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.